वी हैव सीन सो फार दैट इफ वी वॉन्ट टू चार्ज अ बॉडी वी कैन नॉट गिव एनी अमाउंट ऑफ चार्ज टू इट बिकॉज द लीकेज ऑफ चार्ज स्टार्ट्स. नाउ लेट मी टेक अ सिचुएशन दैट दिस इज अ कंडक्टिंग प्लेट एंड दिस इज गिवन अ पॉजिटिव चार्ज. सो देयर विल बी एन इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड हियर एंड विल कीप ऑन इंक्रीजिंग एज वी गिव मोर एंड मोर चार्ज टू इट. नाउ let me keep another charge, another conducting plate close to it. So on the inner surface negative charge will be induced and on the outer surface positive charge will be induced. If I calculate the electric field here, it will be due to plus, due to minus, due to plus. If this is not here, the net field is zero because of plus and minus. Plus in this direction, minus in this direction. So it will be zero if this plus is not there. Similarly, the potential difference between the two, that has decreased because of this minus but has increased because of plus. And we want to reduce the value of the electric field. So what we can do, we can ground this. So this positive will not be here now. This positive is grounded. So now the situation is it is like this. If I ask now again, calculate the electric field here, it is zero. Calculate the electric field here, it is again zero. So by putting a conducting plate close to one conducting plate, the electric field becomes zero. Though it is not zero in between it has increased, though it is localized field. Due to this, it is in this direction, due to this, it is in this direction. But then we can place some dielectric here. If I put some insulating material here, dielectric or insulating material. Say for example, for any medium there is some dielectric constant. If I put here say water between the two plates, water has the value of dielectric constant roughly 80. It means the field will be reduced 80 times. So when we put some dielectric between the plates, the field will be reduced. Here the field has become zero because of this. So it means now the capacity of this capacitor has increased and we can give more charge. This arrangement can act as capacitor. Capacitor means a system where we can store charge. Though again keep in mind that net charge on the capacitor is always zero. This plus this is zero. So when we are talking about the charge on a capacitor, it means charge on any one plate. Okay, and capacity of this capacitor, charge on either plate divided by the potential difference between the two, this is called the capacity or capacitance of the capacitor. It is measured in coulombs per volt. So its unit is farad, or it can be microfarad, picofarad, and it does not depend on the value of charge or this. This depends on geometry. Geometry means size and shape of these plates, distance between them. And it is also dependent on medium. So geometry and medium will determine the value of C, not Q or V. We can find out for this particular, let us say the distance between the plates D, and let A be the area of each plate, same for both, right? Then what will be the potential difference between the two plates? It is a uniform field. Potential difference is always electric field into distance. What about the electric field between two sheets of charge? It is sigma by 2 epsilon naught due to this, and sigma upon 2 epsilon, not because of this. This is the direction of the field, because of this and because of this too. D. So it is sigma by epsilon naught into D. Sigma is charge per unit area. So it will be Q upon A epsilon naught D. So what will be the value of Q upon V? I just rearrange these terms. Q upon V, which is also C, becomes epsilon naught A upon D. So this is the value of capacitance of a plane parallel plate capacitor. Two plates parallel and plane, each one with an area A, the distance between them D. The potential difference will be E into D. E is uniform, right? We have taken large plates and the distance between them very small. And this purpose of putting this, to reduce the value of potential difference and electric field. Just by putting this, electric fields in surroundings become zero. And in between the plates, we can reduce it further by using dielectric. So this is the capacity, and see, it is depending on the area of each plate. So more area means bigger plates. Bigger plates means more capacity, means we can store more charge. Q by V will be more. D is the distance. So more is the separation, less is the capacity. Less distance, more capacity. And this is depending on the medium. See, here we have not taken any specific insulator. We have just taken air, so that's why we are getting epsilon naught. If we take any other medium, it will be replaced by K epsilon naught, where K will be the dielectric constant. So if the medium is filled with a dielectric, the field will be reduced K times. So this will be divided by K. Divided by K. Epsilon naught will be replaced by K epsilon naught, where K is dielectric constant. So this is the permittivity of the medium. It will be K times the permittivity of free space. So this will be the capacity for plane parallel plate capacitor filled with a dielectric. If I use a dielectric but don't fill this space entirely with the dielectric, I take it only for certain part. Okay. It may be like this. So I have taken a dielectric of thickness T and distance between the plates, capacitors plate, it was D. And the initial value of direction of electric field, positive to negative, let it be E naught, be the field between the plates without dielectric. And E naught by K will be within dielectric. This we have already studied. So what happens when a dielectric is placed? Now plus minus the atoms experiences force, positive charge shifts to this side, minus to this side, this surface acquires negative charge, this acquires positive charge. Due to this, internal field is developed. So the net field inside, net field is this one which was earlier, minus the field developed inside, and net field is this one. This is how we define the value of dielectric constant, the factor by which the field is reduced. So even now, even inside, the field is in this direction, but this has a value E naught by K. Outside, the field is E naught. Here the field is E naught, here the field is E naught by K. So how will we write the expression for the potential difference? For T, this is the field. For D minus T, this distance, the field is E naught. For T, field is E naught by K. So E into D, E into D. E naught is sigma by epsilon naught. So it becomes D minus T plus T by K. Sigma is Q upon epsilon naught A. So what is Q by V? It is epsilon naught A upon D minus T plus T upon K. So this is the capacity of a capacitor partially filled with a dielectric. This is a general expression actually, and the expression that we did earlier can also be found from here. If I take D is equal to T, what does it mean? That the entire space is filled with dielectric. So just replace it. What will be C? Epsilon naught A upon D minus D plus D by K. So it becomes K epsilon naught A by D. This is what we did earlier. If the entire space, and if there is no dielectric, then I can write T as 0. So this is 0, this is 0. It becomes epsilon naught A by D. So the general expression for the capacity of a plane parallel plate capacitor with a dielectric is this, if the dielectric is filling the space partially, completely this one. So this gives us, and you can see all these expressions are depending on the medium, on the thickness of the dielectric, distance between the capacitor's plate, area, but independent of charge or potential. So purely geometrical or medium dependent quantity capacity is. And this tells us how much charge can be stored on a particular conductor or here on a particular capacitor. Plane parallel plate capacitor, this is specifically, this is the expression for that.